love somebody, to love somebody the way I love you.
To my brother Alton, greetings from California. Everything is just as we left it, but I can hardly call it home. Mother's lawyer tasked me with combing through the home to discard any of the items not listed in the will. Seeing how she left me nothing, I decided to go alone. I know you'll understand. I trashed the useless clutter, starting with those dreadful owls. Not a single soul at the funeral. However, the guest rooms and dining space suggest she loved company. Not so much as a phone call to her own children in 10 years, yet Barbara could still be the most elegant host. I assumed it would bring me an overdue sense of relief, yet it only presented the question again and again. Why did she leave? I made myself quite comfortable across the property to make up for lost time. I even enjoyed several glasses of the Screaming Eagle. I'm sure you heard there was no one willing to claim her calico, Mr. Lancaster. It seemed the lawyer stopped asking and simply forgot about him. In the master closet, I found the wooden chest you locked yourself inside of on Easter 2002. Contained within were as follows: a deck of playing cards, a cheap cigarette lighter, a flesh-scented candle, a metal tin containing blood pressure medication, a statue of the Demon King Tucci. Among other things.
In the event of something happening to me, there is something I would like you all to see. It's just a photograph of someone that I knew. Have you seen my wife, Mr. Jones? Do you know what it's like on the outside? Don't go talking too loud, you'll cause a landslide, Mr. Jones. I keep straining my ears to hear a sound. Maybe someone.
Perhaps there was a lot we never knew about Barbara. In the same way, she never knew us. Well wishes, your sister Elizabeth.
Those who once existed must be dead. Have you seen my wife, Mr. J?